is flying steady and level at some altitude, deflects the port side aileron up and the starboard aileron down. The aircraft will then, four options, pitch nose up, roll with the starboard wing up, pitch nose down, roll with the port wing up. So first, when you get a question, you have among these four options, you have to slot how you can ignore the options. See, it is written aileron. So what is the function of an aileron? Aileron, it provides a rolling movement. So either it can be option B or D. So you have to choose a question. Its option will be from B and D. So let's see that figure displays in your screen. So this is an aircraft where the right wing says starboard and the left wing call as a port. Left wing call as a port side, and starboard is deflected downwards as it given in the question, and the port wing is deflected upward. So these are the free stream. So what happens when the starboard deflect downwards? So lift takes place on from the starboard side. In case of left wing or a port, what happens? Drag provides. So the lift will be taking place towards the downwards. So how the what will happen? So the starboard will be deflecting from upward direction. So the rolling will be taking place in a clockwise direction. As you can see, the rolling takes place in a clockwise direction. So what will happen? So what is our option? The rolling with the starboard wing up. That is a right option. That is a the right option is option B. Next comes the next question. A Naka 0012 airfoil has a trailing edge flap. The airfoil is operating at an angle of attack of 5 degrees with undeflected flap. If the flap is now deflected by 5 degrees downwards, the CL versus alpha curve. Again, four options, shift right and the slope increases, shift left and the slope increases, shift left and the slope remains same, shift right and the slope remains or stays the same. So here what you have to be clear about the curve between the CL versus alpha curve. So what is mean by CL versus alpha curve? That is a coefficient of lift versus the angle of attack curve. And here they have given the Naka 0012. Here that is a symmetric airfoil, but today we'll see how it works. Here they have given the angle of attack is 15 degree when the flap is not deflected. That is the first condition, not deflected or undeflected one. The second case is when the flap is deflected by 5 degree. There's a second case. Second case is a flap is deflected by 5 degree. So let's see the CL versus alpha curve. So first, before that, let me explain what is mean by flap. Flap is a high lifting device used to increase the lift of an aircraft wing at a given airspeed, and you can see there are a few classification of flap. So here is the CL versus alpha curve. So in the CL curve, the first line you can see here, that is a when the flap is not extended, when the flap is not extended. See, in the second one, when the flap is extended at some angle of attack. See, take any one of the slope remains same at some angle, the slope remains same. Only what happens? Only it moves toward the left and the slope remains same. Only thing, it moves towards the left and slope remains same. So what is our right option? Option C, the C option, the shift left and the slope remains the same. So the right option is option C. Now comes to the last question. The highest limit load factor experienced by an civil transport aircraft is in the range. They have given four range, 0 to 2, second is 2 to 5, C is 5 to 8 and D is 8 to 10. Now let's note these points. There are few categories of airplane been categorized. Like first one you can see for transport category of aircraft, it can range, the load factor can range from minus 1 to plus 2.5. It can also depend on to 3.8 also. See the last one, the utility category. This utility category also can becomes under the civilian transport category, which ranges from minus 1.76 to 4.4. See, aerobatic is 3 to 6.0, helicopter is till 3.5. So from this category we can judge that the right option will be the option B, which ranges from
First question, for an aircraft to be statically stable, the center of gravity must be a height of aerodynamic center, after the aerodynamic center, a height of neutral point and after the neutral point. You must remember this fundamental concept. The center of gravity must lie a height of neutral point when there will be a positive stability, or we can say positive static margin. If the center of gravity lies behind or after the neutral point, that means it is in static, the margin is negative, or it is, or we can say, statically unstable aircraft. So our right option is lies ahead. So right option is answer C. Next comes, for a tailless aircraft, the neutral point coincides with an aerodynamic center. The neutral point lies ahead of the aerodynamic center, and the neutral point lies behind the aerodynamic center, and neutral point lies with the aerodynamic center. See, a tailless aircraft is displayed in your screen. For tailless aircraft, you must remember the neutral point, that is neutral point coincides with the aerodynamic center. So right answer is answer A. Next comes, if an aircraft has its center of gravity at the neutral point, then the aircraft's static stability is minimum, aircraft has a maximum possible stability, aircraft is neutrally stable, none of the above. We call this figure the first one. What happens, the center of gravity lies on the neutral point, and the other two are different. In the first case, we can see what happens to the momentum, it's getting zero. So the aircraft is neutrally stable. So the right answer is answer C. Next comes, for an aircraft considering the wing alone to be destabilizing, the center of gravity must always be ahead of the wing of aerodynamic center, after the wing aerodynamic center, ahead of neutral point and after the neutral point. These are very, very important conceptual questions. So you must remember this concept, that is, typically the wing alone will be negative. That is, when what condition? When the dCmg by d alpha is greater than, that means positive value. So our right answer is answer B, when the wing, that means when the center of gravity lies ahead of the aerodynamic center, then the aircraft is unstable or destabilizing effect. Next comes and as the following, mode 1 and properties. Here we have in group 1, short period mode, wing, rock, guard mode, Dutch roll. And the other side we have a coupling, roll yaw oscillation, angle of attack remains constant, and the roll oscillation speed remains constant. And we have a options. Now before that, let's recall the first one displayed, it is called as Dutch roll. See, it is going, yawing, then again rolling, yawing, rolling. So Dutch roll, we can say it is a combination of or a coupling of a rolling and yawing movement. But in case of roll, long period, you see here what you can see, the angle of attack at each instant along the flight path is essentially constant. That means for long period the angle of attack remains same, and other terms, the speed and altitude varies. In case of short, that is constant speed and altitude, it moves in a constant speed and maintains an on altitude. So if you recall that this match the following, so what is happening, the Dutch roll is getting, it's a coupling between roll and yawing, roll and yawing oscillation. So one, that is I, will go one. So I one is either B or D. Okay. Then we have fugoid. For the fugoid, what we know, the fugoid, we have a constant angle of attack. So H two. So we can see already these two are getting matched up. So other two you may refer back or you may not. So our right option is option B. An aircraft is in state and level flight at a constant speed V. It is disturbed by an asymmetric vertical result in a fugoid period, fugoid oscillation of time period T, assuming that G is the acceleration due to gravity and given approximately by. See, this is a formula. You have to, for a fugoid motion, you have to remember the formula, that is root 2 pi V by G, and the option is option D. A problem. An aircraft in level flight encounters a vertical gust which excites the fugoid mode. The fugoid motion completes 10 cycles in 50 seconds and its amplitude reduced to half of its maximum value in 25 seconds. The eigenvalue of the fugoid mode are. So they are having some set of options. So let's move to the solution. See first what they have given. They have given the number of cycle. Display there number of cycle. Then they have given the half, which is when reducing the time period, what you get from 50 to 25 seconds. Now, this is your general characteristic equation, that is lambda equals to lambda r by plus and minus lambda I. That is, these are the r units for real, imaginary, so we have I complex item. Now, you have to remember this formula, that is t half equals to 25 second equals to 0.693 by lambda r. So from here we can find the lambda, it is 0.028. From there, what you can do is you check the answer question. From here we have only one option, that is 0.028 of lambda r. So it's nothing but our right answer is option C. A damping of a road motion can be improved by high wing, behavioral angle and swept angle. High wing, eleven design, swept angle. Low wing, dihedral angle and swept angles. Low wings, aileron airfoil design and swept angle. So you have to remember, when the damping of a rolling motion takes place, so obviously dihedral angle plays an important role. After dihedral comes a swept angle, because it also increases the lift, then the high angle. So it's nothing but our right answer is option A. Swept angle wing aircraft, the Dutch rule is solved by installing phrase aileron, dihedral angle, yaw damper, all of that. So you have to remember how there is only one way to recover the Dutch rule, is nothing but the yaw damper, that is option C. The Dutch rule damping is increased by lateral directional stability and small dihedral, larger directional stability and small dihedral, larger directional stability and large dihedral, small directional stability and large dihedral. So we have to make a point how we can increase, but our main thing is to decrease. So previous few questions we have seen, for improving we need a high dihedral. So obviously if the Dutch rule is getting increased, so that means we need a small dihedral and directional stability has to be minimum. We cannot make it so.
Here comes a question. Now I will straight away go for the solution. Let me first read the question. For a flight level at cruise altitude, CD value, that is a coefficient of drag, is 0.018 with a drag coefficient at zero lift, CD naught equals to 0.015. For a 30 degree climb at the same altitude and speed, what will be the CD
that value into 10 power minus 3. Now let's see the given data. What are the given data? Given data at cruise condition. What is mean by cruise condition? When the aircraft is flying and when the lift is equivalent to weight and the drag is equivalent to thrust. So at that condition, the total CD, that is CD value, is 0.018, and CD naught, or we can other word we can say a parasite drag, is 0.015. Now the same thing they have asked for 30 degree climb. When the same aircraft is flying, now is the horizon you can see here. Now same aircraft is inclining in 30 degree. So keeping the altitude, one means what is mean altitude? That means density is same, velocity, speed means velocity are same, and likewise since the same aircraft, so to the gross weight aspect ratio or S, that is span area, will be considered to be same. Now see the solution. So these are the cruise condition I have written. So recall a drag polar equation. What is a drag polar equation? CD equals to CD naught plus K CL square. Now we know at cruise condition this two value. We know this two value. Let's apply this two value. So one, when we apply this two value, so we can find the value of K CL square at cruise condition. At cruise condition, we can find the value of K CL square. So when you substitute here, you get 0.03. Let's name this as equation 1. Now what is the next condition? Now when the same aircraft is climbing 30 degree angle with the same rho, V, S and W. What is rho? Density, velocity, span area and the weight of an aircraft. Now this is an, what is this 4 symbol? This 4 symbol represents when an aircraft is leaving a cruise flight. So upward is a lift, downwards, directly downward is a weight, the forward or a flight path is called as thrust, and the opposite of that is called as a drag. So these are the 4 symbol represents. And the same thing when the aircraft, the second condition, when the aircraft is climbing 30 degree, this what happens, the aircraft is traveling to 30 degree. So this was a horizontal and now this became the flight path. Now this becomes a thrust. From here it becomes thrust here, drag here, lift here, but the weight remains same, that is acting downwards, vertically downwards. Now let's see, resolve the forces acting on a plane. So how we can resolve? Either in vertical forces and horizontal forces. So whatever the incline force here, incline, now we will take a reference as a flight path. Remember, don't do a mistake on it. If you are taking a horizon, you will get a different answer, since your wherever the flight path is taking or heading towards, that will be a reference line or reference path. Through that only you have to take or resolve the forces acting on an airplane. So first I have taken the summation of vertical forces. So what are the vertical forces I can see? There is a vertical forces lift and the weight. So upward force means we know is a positive and downward force means negative. So I have resolved this force L minus W cos 30 and it will has to be equivalent to 0. Now I will take a summation of horizontal forces. Now what are the horizontal forces? And similarly, like when it is going on the right hand side, we take as positive. When going the left towards the left hand side, we take as a negative. Positive, negative. So T comes positive, then drag comes negative D minus this weight can be resolved in two parts. One is a cos term, one is another is a sine term. So here when we are taking on horizontal, minus W sine 30 will come. Now you got the resolved force acting on the airplane. Now we are going to solve each. Now I will take the horizontal one. Now consider the horizontal one. At steady level flight, we get as T equals to D, that is thrust equals to drag. And when you apply here, both the terms get cancelled off and you get W equals to whatever the terms is equals to zero. So the weight cannot be zero. So we can ignore this horizontal forces and we can go to the vertical force. Now see, when you go to vertical force, that is lift minus W cos 30 equals zero. Now L equals to W cos 30. Now what is meant by lift formula? Split the formula, half rho V square S CL equals to W cos 30. Now expand little more, keep the CL this side and other terms in another side. And cos 30 means 0.866. So name that an equation. Now what I'm going to do is, I'm going to square the CL square. Both the side. I'm going to square both the side. So when you square both the sides, CL square equals to this and this. Now why I'm doing this is, now after that we need to find the KCL square value. We need to find the KCL square value because again we need to apply the drag polar equation and there we need this. So what I did is, we found the CL square equals to this for when the aircraft is inclining 30 degree. Now I'm going to multiply the K term on both the sides. So we multiplying K on this equation K, and when you square this term and round root of two digital numbers or digital values, we get as 0.75. Squaring of this term, we get as 0.75. Now recall the equation 1. In equation 1, what we have in steady time or cruise flight, KCL square, the value is 0.003. Now what you are going to do is, what is the value of that? Value is this, K2W rho V square S square, right? Now what you are going to do, substitute the equation 1 in equation 2. Instead of this value, we are going to apply that. So when KCL square, this is for 30 degree climb. So when you write 0.003 into 0.75, you get as 0.00225. You get that. Now recalling the drag polar equation again. CD equals to CD naught plus KCL square. What is our requirement? Requirement is to find the CD equals to what are the value into 10 power minus 3 value. Now we know the CD naught value, it's constant because parasite drag, what is my parasite drag? So what is mean by parasite drag? It depends on the aircraft body and pressure that will remain constant for an aircraft. So CD naught value will be same what has been given here, that is 0.015, and KCL square for, this is for, we are finding for 30 degree climb. So this value we have to apply here. See here, see now apply here, we get at 0.01725, right? So that means when you take as, we need to find what is this term into 10 power minus 3, and when you get as 17.25 into 10 power 6, sorry 3, and here they have not mentioned any two decimal places or any places, so better I prefer you better go for any two decimal places at least. And the answer ranges from 17 point of an aircraft. Frequency is directly proportional to the flight speed. Frequency is inversely proportional to the flight speed. Frequency is directly proportional to the square root of flight speed. Frequency is inversely proportional to the square root of flight speed. Now I will come for the explanation. First, you remember what is mean by fugoid mode? Fugoid mode, one of the longitudinal mode. Okay, now, and it consists of a long period of frequency where you have to remember this formula. Omega means it's a natural frequency, is equivalent to root over 2 g by u naught. U naught defines the flight speed and g refers to the acceleration due to gravity. So This explains frequency is inversely proportional to the flight speed. So the answer is B. And also you note down this thing, the time period of oscillation is proportional to the velocity. Sometimes or some other times they can ask this question. So you remember this formula, T, that is time period equals to 2 pi by omega. So answer is B. Come to the next question. An aircraft in trim condition has a zero pitching moment at option A, its aerodynamic center, its center of gravity, 25% of its mean aerodynamic chord and 50% of its wing root chord. Now explanation. So remember this diagram which is appearing in front of your screen. Here all the total weight or the gross weight acting vertically downwards. So whenever the trim condition or stability point of view, you have to focus that CG is an important thing. On the CG, where the pitching moment becomes zero at trim condition or equilibrium condition, this is a condition of an aircraft to maintain a static stability. What happens? That is, the moment coefficient at CG becomes zero at trim condition or an equilibrium condition. So our option is option B. Comes the next question. The pitching angle and the angle of attack for an fixed wing aircraft are equal during wings level constant altitude flight, unaccelerated climb, unaccelerated descent and landing. Now see the explanation. See, remember this diagram. You are taking a flight path is called as a pitching angle. An angle of attack is different from the pitching angle. But in the question, what they have asked, when the pitching angle and the angle of attack is same, at what condition? So see that explanation. The pitching altitude and the angle of attack will be same or equal. The aircraft could only fly straight ahead at the same altitude. That means if this and this angle become same, so what will happen? Both will fly on the same altitude. So our option is option A. So I hope your doubt has been true. A speed of 200 meter per second and it is performing a climb at an climb angle of 15 degree. The aircraft is experiencing a tailwind of 10 meter per second. Calculate the horizontal ground speed of the aircraft. So these are the options has been given in the question. So when you know that when there is an option has been given in a problem, that problem consists of negative mark. So you have to solve the problem very, very carefully. So now it's time for explanation. So here is the aircraft. It is in horizontal. Now the same aircraft will tilting in the 15 degree angle. Here comes a 15 degree angle. Now a true air speed of 200 meter per second, then a tailwind of 10 meter per second, and what we need to find, that is a ground speed or ground velocity of the aircraft. So you have to be very careful when you put a tailwind, because what is mean by tailwind? The direction is very important, or we can say the arrowhead direction is very important for this kind of problems. If you keep in a reverse way, your entire sum will be different. So make sure the tailwind, that means it is heading towards the tail, that's why the arrowhead is kept on this side. And true air speed, that is true air speed, will be parallel to the horizon, so that's why I kept this way, 200 meter per second. And from here to this is a flight path. From here to this TAS, this
true airspeed is 15 degree inclined and horizontal ground speed. Horizontal ground speed doesn't mean that it will be inclined. That means at what relative speed it is moving with respect to the ground. So I hope this diagram or schematic diagram is clear for you. Now it's time to resolve the forces acting on the aircraft. So how we can resolve the forces? Here we can't resolve on the vertical, let's resolve on the horizontal forces. Resolve the forces, what we get is plus 10, because the arrow hits its towards on the right. So right side direction is positive and the left side will be a negative. So plus 10 plus, now here this TAS is inclining 15 degree this side. So when you resolve this force, it will come as 200 cos 15 degree minus VD, because the directing towards the left, so it will be a minus equals to 0. Now by simplifying the equation, what you get, VG equals to 10 plus 200 cos 15. Now you apply on your calculator, virtual calculator, cos 15, how much it comes, and apply that, and you get as 10 plus 993.19. So when you solve it, you get as 203.19 meter per second, and round up we can say as 203.2 meter per second, and which is your answer D. So in this problem you have to be carefully note about the arrowhead. That is very important to solve the problem, and when there is an option there is a negative mark, please make a note of it. I hope